Devastated at the loss of the AFC title for the Patriots.
Three lucky people claim the $1.6 billion Powerball prize.
And bomb threats to our very own Newton North High School suspend classes in the middle of the day. Good evening, I'm Gabe Katsonis.
And I'm Naya Belinda, and this is Newton North News.
In recent news around the globe, Charlie Hebdo, infamous French satire magazine, has recently published yet another controversial cartoon. Depicted in the comic is three-year-old Syrian refugee Alon Kurdi, who made headlines after a photo of his body washed ashore went viral. The cartoon shows Kurdi as an adult, saying he would become a sexual molester had he grown up. This sparked a lot of outrage, similar to the cartoon of Muhammad they released last year.
This past month has had everyone talking about the $1.6 billion Powerball drawing, the highest ever. Three lucky people from across the country managed to overcome the odds of 1 in 292 million and claim the massive prize. These winners, located in California, Florida, and Tennessee, will each receive $533 million over the next 30 years.
In local news, Boston kicks off its annual Boston Marathon this April. This will mark 3 years since the Boston Marathon bombing in 2013 and 120 since its start in 1897. The marathon is scheduled to take place on Monday, April 18th, and has an expected turnout in the tens of thousands.
Closer to home, last Tuesday, January 19th, Newton North High School, along with multiple other schools in New England, received bomb threats via an anonymous source. This resulted in a lockdown of all D-block classes and a schedule change for the rest of the day, as authorities set the school looking for any suspicious objects.
In sports news, the New England Patriots took a tough loss against the Denver Broncos for the AFC title this past Sunday. With 12 seconds to go, the Pats scored a 4-yard touchdown to bring the score up to 18-20. Sadly, they were unable to tie up the score and take the game into overtime, leading to an end of the season for them.
This past weekend, cities all along the eastern seaboard were hit by a major winter storm with snowfall upwards of 3 feet in certain places, a death toll of at least 30, and thousands without power. It has been declared a state of emergency. Thankfully, communities are bouncing back and public transportation is slowly returning to normal. Once again, I'm Naya Belinda.
And I'm Gabe Katsonis, and that's the way the news goes.